For several decades, the Uganda Police housing units in different districts have been an eyesore given their dilapidated state. Thousands of low-ranking police officers are still residing in the dilapidated colonial structures, which is putting their lives and the lives of their dependents at stake. Last year, the police force commissioned 420 housing units, but these are just a drop in an ocean. Speaking at the 27th Police Council meeting, the Minister of Internal Affairs, General Kahinde Otafire, echoed the demand for decent housing for police officers. He ordered the Finance Ministry to avail funds for the construction of houses, especially the lower rank officers.
Under Secretary, I want an answer within 3 months if I'm still here. If there is no answer to the police prison housing, what you will go. 3 months, 90 days, beginning today. I want an answer. You had me. You had me. I am coming from your end. I want an answer because we are tired of having police officers sleeping in shameful conditions. Like I said in Masindi, those who are there, a healthy mind is in a healthy body. This police officer who works at the Ginger Road and sleeps in where you get it. Ginger Road and the friends where you get it in the countryside, in the village there.
Kahinde noted that it is shameful to see police officers sleep in very dangerous structures, yet they play an important role in protecting other Ugandans and their property. He also instructed the force to improve the clothing aspect, as well as ensure that all police officers are adequately equipped for their job.
I want serious housing for police officers. At least we'll begin. Then equipment, especially clothing. Every police officer should be entitled to at least 2 pairs of clothes. Boots, warm suit. Sometimes I feel sorry for police officers when you find them patrolling at night without warm suit. You find them, these fellows are there miserable and to make their work easy.
Furthermore, Otafire implored the police leadership to strengthen their structures to enable the implementation of sub-county policing among other modern policing methods.
Because when I go up country, most of the police officers, most of the DPC say, when I find that, help us with manpower. They help, we don't have manpower. But I don't refer to the manpower, it's the chief of human resources.
More than proactive community policy through technology for a secure and prosperous society. It is for discussion in this 27th Police Council. This theme is more appropriate since we are operationalizing the sub-county policy model that is aimed at improving the quality of services that we offer to the public.
The Police Human Resource Director, Brigadier Jessica Mnanwire, explained the objectives of a two-day police council meeting.
As we deliberate on the various issues at hand, let us keep in mind the noble purpose that unites us all. That is the protection of our communities, the upholding of justice, and the preservation of the rule of law. Our collective efforts today will undoubtedly contribute to the betterment of law enforcement practices and the enhancement of public safety.